Welcome to our service for the Sunday of Epiphany. Let us follow the star with the wise men.
Stars cross the sky. Wise men journey from pagan lands. Earth receives its saviour in a cave. Let there be no one without a gift to offer. No one without gratitude. As we celebrate the salvation of the world. On this Epiphany Sunday, we come before God to worship and adore him.
So we sing our first hymn, Brightest and Best.
Brightest and best of the stars of the morning, dawn on our darkness and lend us your aid. Star of the east, the horizon adoring, guide where our infant Redeemer is laid. Cold on his cradle, the dewdrops are shining, low lies his head with the peace of the storm. Angels adore him in summer reclining, Maker of all and Saviour of all. Say, shall we yield him because
ever-loving God, on this Epiphany, we come before you. We are still the people walking. We are still people in the dark. And the darkness looms large around us, beset as we are by our fears and anxieties, our worries and our doubts. A dozen alienations that we cannot manage. We could be people of your light. So we come before you prayerfully this day, praying for the light of your glorious presence as we wait for your appearing. We pray for the light of your wondrous grace as we exhaust our coping capacity. We pray for your gift of newness that will override our weariness. We pray that we may see and know and hear and trust in your good rule. We pray that we may have energy, courage, and freedom to enact your rule through the demands of this day. And we submit our time to you now and to your rule with deep joy and high hope. We come before you to worship and adore you. Hopeful that you will meet us where we are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We share in the words of the Lord's Prayer together. Let us pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
So this Christmastide began with the first Sunday of Advent, marked by expectation and anticipation all the way through to Christmas, and concludes with Epiphany, celebrated on the 6th of January, the day after the 12th night. Decorations come down, the tree is dismantled, and we set our eyes forward from this point, journeying on, taking the message of Christmas out into the world. Is this the start of the end of a season? Or is it the end of the beginning of a story that has much yet to unfold? The word epiphany is itself a bit of a mouthful, but its meaning is quite simple. It means to show. It means to make known, to reveal. It's a word that has made its way into our common language. To have an epiphany is to realise something we didn't know before. Something that's usually obvious once realised, but not quite clear to us before. Something surprising or unusual, a discovery that's wrapped with exhilaration. Not usually associated with negative discoveries, but positive, encouraging, helpful realisations that enable us in some way. And it seems appropriate, therefore, that this time of year, when we recall the story of the wise men who bring gifts to the infant Jesus, that we call this time of year Epiphany. For they discover God really has come down to earth as flesh, Emmanuel, and that this Christ child will be king for all people, Jews and Gentiles, for everybody, everywhere. They are the first non-Jews that we're told about who acknowledge Jesus as king. These strangers from a far-off land, guided by a star, discover, realize, make known by their actions that God is with us. Here for the many, not just the few. These wise, respected men of their day had seen in the stars that something wonderful was happening, and they travelled to that house in Bethlehem, not because they wanted to make the headlines, not because they wanted to influence the rich and the powerful by their findings. They go quietly, humbly. They go because they feel drawn to something bigger than themselves. What they had seen in the stars, could it be true? And as they enter the room where the infant child is, by their actions of kneeling, offering gifts of meaning, of value, of purpose, by their decision afterwards not to go back to Herod, but to seek a different road home, by all of that, we see and share their epiphany as we retell their story, relive that moment of realization that Christ is indeed God with us, King of Kings, Prince of Peace. Well, many cultures around the world will see this day, this time within the Christmas period, as the time to give gifts, not on Christmas Day, but on the day of Epiphany, to celebrate the realization that God has come for us all. Regardless of who we are, where we are born, where we live, what we do, or whatever has happened in our past, God comes to all. And the barrier of race, gender, background, ability, or anything else is no more. From when those first Gentiles, those first strangers, those first wise men kneel before him and present him with gifts fit for a king. It was indeed an epiphany. An epiphany we can all share in. They give him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They give him gold. Gold in those days was the usual offering presented to kings by their subjects or by those wanting to pay their respects. Gold has always represented great value. It's really scarce, which makes it very valuable. It's warmly beautiful. And it's enduring. Gold can withstand all natural acids and even fire. And the wise men brought gold to honour Christ as they would a king. A king for all. In Paul's letter to Ephesians, he writes these words. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring to the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ. the wise men bring gold, and honour him as the king. A king made real and accessible to us all through his coming as a human being like you and I. And we are asked to honour him as our king, to believe the predictions of those wise men, to believe they were realised for all. They give him frankincense, a very costly and fragrant gum, distilled from a tree you can find in Persia, India and Arabia, as well as in the East Indies. It's a white resin or gum, and it's obtained by slitting the bark of the arborithurium tree and allowing the gum to flow out, a white coloured juice. Frankincense means whiteness. It's highly fragrant, and when burned, used in worship, where it burns as a pleasant offering to God. It would have been used as medicine and also as a perfume. It represents worship that is pleasing to God. And the wise men brought frankincense to offer sweet worship to this king before them. As Christians, we are a community, and part of our covenant with God is a commitment to worship him with others in our own homes and spaces, in our lives, relevant, fulfilling, prayerful, reflective worship. To worship God is to simply spend time in his presence, with God at the centre of our thoughts, our minds, our actions, adoringly, gratefully, worshipping him sweetly. The wise men bring frankincense, and they bring myrrh. Myrrh is an aromatic gum produced from a thorn bush grown in Arabia and Ethiopia, obtained from a tree in the same manner as frankincense. But whilst frankincense represents sweetness, myrrh represents bitterness, at least to the taste. In those days, myrrh was often used to embalm the dead. Was myrrh brought as a gift to acknowledge the human suffering that Jesus would partake of by entering into our world? Does it also remind us of our own brokenness and the need of healing and soothing? Myrrh today is used in various medical areas to soothe discomforts in the human body. The wise men present him with the gift of myrrh, perhaps the most costly and significant gift they had. They present this to the king before them.
Three kings from Persian lands afar to Jordan follow the pointing stars, and this the quest of the traveler's dream, where the newborn king of the Jews may be. For royal gifts they bear for the king, gold, incense, myrrh are their offering. The star shines out with a steadfast ray, the kings to Bethlehem make their way, and then in worship they bend the knee as Mary's child in her lap they see. Their royal gifts they show to the king, gold, incense,
offer thy heart to him.
gold, frankincense, myrrh, all gifts fit for a god and king, offered by strangers from a foreign land whose revelation at their encounter opened the way for those who see themselves as outsiders to discover they can be insiders. They can be part of this king's kingdom, a kingdom without barriers, built on unending love offered to us all by grace. We are a mixed bag of folk in our churches, and we're a mixed bag of folk in our communities today, and we are the richer for it. We're all different, and yet we are all equal in the eyes of God. We are all strangers in each other's lands, but we are none of us strangers to God through Christ. We're all individuals with gifts to offer to our King, and none of us are too weak, too old, too young, too tired, too unqualified, too overqualified, too unsure, too whatever, to be part of his kingdom, because it's built on grace. But I wonder, for someone so amazing as Christ, our God and King, who welcomes us without question to be part of his kingdom, I wonder, what will be our gold offering to him? What a value in ourselves can we give to him? And I wonder, what will be our frankincense? What sweet worship will we engage in, invite others to, be part of, that's worthy of a king? And what will be our myrrh? What part of ourselves is perhaps a little bit broken, a little bit scarred, that we need to let God take care of? What soothing do we need for our souls? And how might we be soothing to others by the grace of God working through us in our daily lives? We've got the greatest gift of all right before our eyes. All we need is our own epiphany to realise it for ourselves. We never find out what happened next to the wise men. Their stories do not play out in any of the gospel narratives after their first encounter with Christ, and I often wonder what happened to them. Listen to one poet's words of how Balthazar, the black king, may have felt as he heads home.
Look at the revival. By Teresa Lola. I am heading home, carrying the strange weight of my last encounter. A child shouts, Balthazar the Black King. The words shake in my ear like a drunk fly. The ground seems to be opening its teeth, either to bite or to kiss me. My eyes feel foreign. I guess to know deeply, one must look deeply. Plants are blooming from the ground. Their leaves have the surreal spread of angel wings. Bewildered, I swallow ginger powder, hoping the sharp taste will jolt me awake from this strange scene. Stars begin falling like a rainy revival. Should I promise my people this is hope arriving? My job often feels like a hefty stone, but today I am powered by a fierce awe. I say to the stunned people, let us look deeply. To know this hope deeply.
Let us look deeply to know this hope deeply. Should we promise people this is hope arriving? Let us look deeply to know this hope deeply. Looking deeply within ourselves, come with your gold, your frankincense, and your myrrh. Come and discover the hope within for a world without. Come and kneel before him. Look deeply in your heart, mind and soul. Offer them to him once more. This can be your epiphany. This can be mine. This is hope arriving. Look deeply and know this hope deeply. For God is with us, Emmanuel, King of Kings, Prince of Peace, and Lord for all. So let's kneel and adore our God and King. Look deeply and know this hope deeply. Amen.
Afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star, the star. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over a soul to reign. O star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh, prayer and praising, all men raising, worship him God most high. Star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect
And so we pray. It's written in the stars that you will meet a tall, dark stranger. It's written in the stars that you should pay special attention to finance this month. It's written in the stars that it's a good year for a change of career. It's written in the stars that your health will take a turn for the better today. Ever-loving God, sometimes it seems as if our lives are out of control. Relationships, money, employment, health. We pray for those who feel as though they have lost their grip. Those who feel that life is running away from them. We pray they follow your star. It's written in the stars that famine will strike somewhere. It's written in the stars that a war will break out somewhere. It's written in the stars that a natural disaster will strike when we least expect it. It is written in the stars that there'll be a big scandal. Ever loving God, sometimes it seems as if the world is spinning out of control. Poverty, conflict, disaster, sleaze. We pray for those who feel they are mere pawns in a bigger global game. Those who feel they simply don't get a fair chance at life. We pray they discover your star. It is written in the stars that a saviour will be born. It is written in the stars that Bethlehem is the place. It is written in the stars that shepherds and kings will bow down and worship. It is written in the stars that he is Emmanuel, God with us. Ever-loving God, make that real for us. Show us how our lives are not written in the stars, but on the palm of your hand. Show us how the world is not at the mercy of fate, but encircled by your love. Show us how our lives are not cast in stone, but moulded like clay for your purpose. O God, who made the stars, hear our prayer. Amen.
Our final hymn, As With Gladness, Men of Old. So a blessing. May your eyes be open to the wonder of the daily miracles around you and your sense of mystery be deepened. May you be aware of the light that shines in the darkness and that the darkness can never put out. May you be blessed with companions on your journey, friends who will listen to you and encourage you with their presence. May you learn to live with what is unsolved in your heart, daring to face the questions and holding them until one day they find their answers. May you find the still, quiet place inside yourself where you can know and experience the peace that passes all understanding. May love flow in you and through you to those who need you. May you continue to dream dreams and to reach out into the future with a deeper understanding of God's way for you. May you find your way towards His star, towards His way, His truth, and His life. Now and forevermore, this blessing we pray.
God be with you now and always. Amen.